ran by the Bears 38-17. Teddy Bridgewater, a total of 5 touchdowns. The Patriots blew out the Titans 33-16. Marcus Mariota left the game with a knee injury. Danny Amendola, same thing, forced out with a left knee injury, did not return for New England. The Chiefs, they continue to roll. They were looking for win number 8 in a row, and Alex Smith obliged.
1st and 10 Chiefs just inside the 14 of the Ravens, going right to left now in this second quarter. In the pocket, snap, had it caught, touchdown! Kansas City, Jeremy Maclin holds in the pass, burning Kendrick Lewis.
101, the Fox and the Chiefs radio network on the call. Kansas City routed the Ravens 34-14, and yes, that is 8 straight wins. For the rest of your NFL scores, go to NBCSportsRadio.com. Moving to the NBA, Cavs taking on the Sixers. Easy game, 108-86, a victory for Cleveland. Kyrie Irving, first game back of the season since dislocating his knee in the NBA Finals. In 17 minutes, Irving, 5 of 12 shooting, 12 points, and 4 assists. Remember to listen to NBC Sports Radio on your local station, online, and on the mobile app. I'm Keith Irizarry.
This is KCAA.
BuySellMakeOffer.com is our New Year's gift to you. Circle this date, Friday, January 15th. You're invited to start the new year off right with a subscription to BuySellMakeOffer.com. Some other selling sites can be sketchy, and even others will charge you a fee on every item you list. But with BuySellMakeOffer.com, you can sell your washer, dryer, cars, or even your home with no per-item fees. And you can use Skype, make a video. You can actually see the person you're buying from, or they can see you, all to better sell your product. Wouldn't you like a feeling of security when you buy or sell? That's why we call it BuySellMakeOffer.com. And you don't have to wait until January 15th to find out what the buzz is all about. Go right now to BuySellMakeOffer.com and type in your email address so you'll know exactly when the fun will begin. The first 30 days are on us, and then it's as little as $7.95 per month to sell up to 50 items. Join the revolution in online selling with BuySellMakeOffer.com.
The most diversified radio station on the dial, KCAA. From the KCAA Weather Center, I'm Rod Tanner. For this afternoon, you're going to be partly sunny with a high 59. Left party cloudy conditions overnight with a low of 43. We'll have a mostly sunny Monday, our high 63. There's a chance of a shower Monday night. You're going to be mostly cloudy at a 49. There's a 20% chance of rain Tuesday. We'll have a partly sunny day with a high of 66. A 2 in 10 chance of showers continues Tuesday night. You're going to be mostly cloudy at a 53. There's a chance of rain Wednesday morning. We'll have a mostly sunny day with a high of 66. Again, today's high 59, and that's your forecast for this hour from KCAA, 106.5 FM and 1050 AM, the stations that leave no listener behind.
KCAA and KCAA Internet Television, the station that leaves no listener and no viewer behind.
Good afternoon, gente. This is the commish along with CX2 right here at KCAA Radio in the studio live. And with us today, we have Mama Liz out here somewhere who's running around chit-chatting about all the great activities going on. And with us today in the studio is we have Richard Hotto. He's here with Plastic Panzers. As you can see, those of you that can't, that are out there on the internet at kcaaradio.com, as you can see, we have these Panzer replicas. These are military battleground tanks, and we're going to be talking to Richard a little bit about these military vehicles that they designed, they put together, and they can ship these things worldwide. So we'll talk with Richard a little bit more later on the show. But right now, CX2 and I, we just really want to wish some people out there a happy birthday. And first of all, we want to wish President Romo with the Aztec Riders. It's his birthday. He's out of the city of Fontana. And then also we have Miss Lily Houston in the city of Rialto, who's celebrating a birthday. And then we have our homeboy with Group Car Club, Mr. Raul Sanchez, out there in the city of Riverside. And we have Mr. Jeremy Baca, the son to former Congressman Joe Baca, who's celebrating his birthday. And then also on December 22nd, Cecilia Aparicio with the city's finest car club is also going to be celebrating her birthday. And then we have a birthday coming up of one of our own, Jessica Baeza. She's getting I was going to say she's getting old. She's getting younger, huh? What do you think, CXT? She getting younger?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we want to wish everybody a happy birthday out there. And, you know, stay safe this holiday season. And we want to wish you a Merry Christmas. And also, you got something you want to talk about, DJ CXT?
Well, this past weekend, week on Tuesday, DJ Cynthia had gone through some surgeries, and I want to wish her well and a speedy recovery. And we love you, DJ Cynthia.
Oh, yeah, DJ Cynthia De La Rosa from the city of Colton. Yeah, she had some surgery this past week. So, yeah, best wishes to you, DJ Cynthia. Hurry up. We want a full recovery on you. That's it. You know, good-hearted person. Anyways, with that right now, what else do we got going, CX2? I know you and I, we've been really busy, huh?
Yeah.
And come on in here, JoJo. Shoot, just get over here and reach it. Put that down for a second, brother. We got right here JoJo Devotions right here. Or JoJo Divine. Is it Divine? It's JoJo Divine, right?
Why are you trying to tease me with the water, eh?
I don't know, eh? You're like missed. I thought it was the stretch, eh? I was in here trying to, like, you know?
I don't know, but these things right here are pretty nice.
Right on. But how's it going, man?
No, I was thirsty.
Okay, that's how it's going, huh? You're thirsty?
No, we're doing everybody's birthdays today. You know what I mean? You ever had that family that has that many birthdays in one day?
Somos Mexicanos, eh? We celebrate a birthday every day, Mo. I don't know, where you been?
I celebrate their birthday like, I'll get you this now, but it's for your birthday.
Most of the time, it's all my children that I didn't have.
Like my mijo that called in the other day.
Yeah, like your mijo that called in the other day. So, yeah, man, a lot of birthdays this month, man. This month of December, man. I hate it, though, when I'd rather everybody party at once, eh? Because, you know, us Mexicanos, it's like every month there's a birthday or a quinceañera or a wedding or something we're going to, you know?
Then we all pitch in one time, say, that's all for you guys.
Yeah, that's it.
Break it and take home a piece.
Yeah, man. How's it going out there? I know you cover Riverside a lot, man. So how's it going out there?
We've been really busy in Riverside. We actually been up and down right there, the downtown, checking out the lights.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you guys haven't checked out the lights downtown Riverside, you have another week and a half.
Yeah, man, beautiful. You know, when they do the lighting ceremony, man, over there at the Mission Inn, beautiful, man.
CXT, and it's an everyday thing. I thought it was just the weekends until me and the kids went riding down there Tuesday or something, and there's stuff going on every single day down there.
Yeah, matter of fact, man, talking about Riverside too, dude, I want to give a shout-out out there to the Viejitos Nomads. Georgie Marquecho and Carlos are out there. They're listening in right now, checking out the show. You know, and a big shout out to them out there, to my primo and to Carlos. You know, hope you guys are having a great day, man. Kicking back, having a cerveza.
They were supposed to be in here earlier.
Were they?
Yeah.
They were supposed to be in here? No, dale. So, man, well, hopefully they'll come out tonight, man, because we got something going down tonight right here at the Carousel Mall, right? You want to tell us a little bit about it, JoJo?
Actually, if you guys don't know, it's the Carousel Malls, or the Suavecitos Car Club's second annual car light-up show. I think that's how they're calling it.
Right.
Santa Claus will be here. All the rides, light lit up, just looking like those block parties.
Right on. And from what time to what time, brother?
What was it 5 to 9?
5 to 9, or probably 5 to 10. We'll probably extend it tonight, huh?
No, they have the noise ordinance. So that means all the children got to play their own music, which is nothing new.
Yeah.
Shoot. Like when mom says go to bed and everybody stays up.
Yeah, I was thinking about bringing my canister, you know, the washing machine canister that I used to do my bonfires in the backyard. I was going to bring it out here today, but then I said, I'll probably get chased away or something.
No, they'll be everybody's best friend.
Yeah, everybody, keep everybody warm, eh? But, yeah, man, so, you know, CX2 and myself, bro, we've been busy too, man, out here towards San Bernardino, man. Yesterday we had 3 events we went to. We had the first event we went to was for the Seeds of Hope in the city of Colton. They had their toy giveaway yesterday, man. I don't know how many kids we gave out toys to, bro. And then from that event, we went over to one of our local teams, the Nighthawks baseball team. Some youngsters, man, they celebrated Christmas and, you know, all got together. And DJ CX2 and myself, we went out there, and along with Frijolito Claus, we went out there and celebrated with them. And then from there, man, we went over to the Lighthouse Foster Care Services, and they had their annual Christmas dinner. They actually are the agency that puts the kids that are in the foster care program in Riverside and San Bernardino County. They put them in the homes. So there was, I don't know, a couple hundred, 250 kids that were there that received toys from, you know, Santa, and they had a great little party going on, and CX2 got down, you know, she really got the kids going, man, out there. Nah, you got to ran all that sugar out of them last night.
Fearfully, so. Give out more, or actually, we do give out more gifts out and about than to ourselves.
Yeah, that's good, dude. You know, I don't need no gifts. I pretty much have everything I need.
I got you tamales, you know, yeah. Want them?
Mm-hmm. Tamales, eh?
I mean, I could eat them myself.
Right? Yeah, you're good.
I ordered you a batch.
Orale. Shit. Well, you can just drop those off.
But before you get started on your show, I want to actually give a big shout out to our own Voodoo Doll.
Yeah, what's up with Voodoo Doll?
She just finished her classes for surgical technician.
Oh, right on. Congratulations, Voodoo
and
Doll.
She has her test Monday. What is that, 300 something wow. Questions? Yeah, I can tell you how to dissect and get rid of bodies by next week. Don't worry about it.
Cool, man. That's crazy. So, yeah, brother. So, congratulations, every Voodoo Doll, man. We're all proud of you right here at KCAA Radio. And right now, we're going to go to DJ CX2 with some jams.
All right, you guys.
And we'll have Richard Harrell come up from Plastic Panzers. Thank you. good Sunday afternoon, and this is Kcaa 1050 AM 106.5 FM, the station that leaves no listener behind. And you're listening to the Commish and DJ CX2 show right here. And with us this afternoon, we have Richard Harrow. He's here from Plastic Panzers. They're builders of replicas 1/16 models of World War II military battleground vehicles. How you doing today, Richard?
Real good, thank you. Thank you for having me here.
You're welcome. And you want to tell us a little bit about Plastic Panzers?
Well, Plastic Panzers was born in 2000. We've been around for about 15 years, and it started out as a group of hobbyists, and we got together and wanted to make authentic replicas in 1/6 scale of World War II vehicles, and that's mainly what we do. We do have one modern vehicle in our lineup, which is an M113, which was used from Vietnam forward.
Right, right. And, yeah, like you were saying, I read on your website that originally you guys started out with, like, three builders?
Correct.
And then you guys kind of just expanded, huh?
Right. Well, three main builders, myself included, my friend Calvin Yip and Tim Loeb. And we also had other people that did other parts of it, because all these vehicles take different pieces. Like, some take resin parts. So we had one guy that did all our resin casting for us. We had other guys that did the track links. Those we had imported from Japan, or actually from China.
Okay.
Everything else is built here in the U.S., though.
Yeah. And I was trying to find out when you first shared with me, you know, I wasn't aware of what Panzer meant. Can you tell us a little bit what Panzer meant?
Panzer is German for tank. And Plastic Panzers meant German plastic tank, basically. And during World War II, the Americans called the German tanks the Panzers. You know, it was the Tiger or the Panzers.
Right.
Basically, that's what it was. The Americans had different numbering systems for their tanks. They would call them, like, the one in front of you here on the webcast, if you guys see it. This is an M10, which was called a tank destroyer. The Americans decided that they didn't want to put their regular tanks, the tank doctrine in World War II was the Shermans were actually infantry support. They would come up behind the infantry and knock out hard spots. Then they found out that they didn't want to go tank to tank with those tanks, so they developed tank destroyers, which were faster, generally had heavier guns and things to take out the other tanks.
Okay. Yeah. And then you brought two beautiful models with you here today. So you told us a little bit about this one on the table, and then you have another one over here on the floor. Would you like me to, so you can speak about it, I can pick it up and show it in front of the camera?
Sure, if you like.
Okay, go ahead. You can keep talking.
The other one I brought today is not painted up. It's very basic, like pretty much out of the box. This is a World War II German reconnaissance vehicle. It was called the Puma. It was 8 wheels and had a turret, had a small gun on it, and was very fast, and the Germans used it as reconnaissance. They actually used all their vehicles in many different ways. This one was used basically in 4 different configurations. They had an anti-aircraft gun on one. This is mainly the reconnaissance version. And as you can see, they come right out of the box, and they're pretty easy builds. Most of our vehicles are easier to build, and they're very durable. The plastic that we use to make them is called a rotomold process, and it's kind of like what they use to make trash cans, but a little stiffer. It's a resin, and the reason they call it rotomold is because they have this big clamshell, which is the mold, and they put this powder in it, which is the resin, and they put it into an oven, and it heats it up, and as it's heating it up, they're spinning it. So it turns to a liquid, and it covers the whole inside. And then it goes into another room, which is the cooler, and it gets hit instantly with cold water, and the liquid hardens real quick.
Okay.
And then they do it all over again. It's an interesting process.
Wow. Very interesting process of how you guys put these together. So what I'm seeing here, this is a complete tank in front of me.
Mm-hmm.
So if me as a beginner, or if I wanted to put something together, do you guys will send the pieces like a model, or can I purchase it this way?
Well, we have different levels. We have the model kit for those who want to do the whole thing, and they can put their own spin on it, and they can make it their own, whichever detailing they want. We have a light build, which is a basic build, just basically puts the tracks and does minor things, and then you can detail it out however you want.
Okay.
We have links on our website to other manufacturers that make all kinds of detail pieces. We partnered with a friend back east called East Coast Armory, and he makes a complete interior detail kit. So you cannot tell by looking at the pictures if it's a real tank or if it's a model. It's that accurate. It's just tremendous.
Wow. And what are we looking at as far as like price ranges on something like this that's right here on the table?
Well, this one here is about $1,000 the way you see it.
Wow.
As a kit.
And it comes, let me ask you real quick,
yeah.
And it comes with the figures? With the figures?
No.
Okay.
The figures would be separate.
Okay.
And but as a kit, it's about $450. So you can see where the, and this one isn't a highly detailed, this is about a mid-range detail.
Okay.
Yeah.
Beautiful tanks.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
And I've even had some people motorize them fully, make them fully remote control. I even had one guy back east in Florida that bought like six of them. And put paintballs in them, and he plays with them in his backyard and shoot.
They shoot each other.
Yeah, they run around and shoot each other with the paintballs. It's really kind of cool.
Well, yeah, I mean, you can pretty much do about anything you want with them once you get the kit, huh? Put it together, and
absolutely.
I mean, it's like it would be a great, I guess, a great hobby, you know, for a dad and a son, or even a daughter who's in the military. I guess and,
absolutely.
You know, they could work together on it. Would be something that I think would be great to work together with your son or daughter on them.
Oh, absolutely. And you know what? It's unfortunate, but model building is becoming a lost art. Many people today want to buy it, open the package, and have it.
Right.
They don't know how to put it together. They don't know how to build a model. They don't know how to paint. They don't know how to use airbrushes and razor blade knives, you know, X-Acto knives, and all the things that we used to do when we were kids. And it's unfortunate. It's a lost art. And I remember when I was a kid, I used to save a lot of my money. You know, my lunch money, I'd save a little bit here and there.
Right.
And then in the week, I'd go to the swap meets and I'd buy model kits.
That's it?
And I loved it because I learned history, too, because all the model kits, the first page of the model kit tells you the history of whatever you're building. If it was a ship, it tells you what it did, where it was. If it was a tank, it tells you when it was made, you know, tell you about the gun and the crew and everything. So I learned a lot of history, and it intrigued me tremendously.
Yeah. And you're right, you know, because I'm a car enthusiast, but I have a lot of model cars, you know, but they're already pre-built. So, you know, I buy them and display them just about, that's about it, you know. When I was younger, you know, we used to buy the little model kits, you know, and put them together and paint them. And, you know, you get all, like, frustrated because, you know, the line came out wrong. Or, No, it was all, you know, it was all part of learning patience and having that hobby and doing something with your mind and your hands, you know?
Exactly.
And I know you guys have a layaway plan if someone wanted to purchase these, right?
Absolutely. They can put a down payment on them, and then we ship after the last payment's received. It's great. It helps defer the cost so it's not such a big hit all at one time.
Absolutely.
And, you know, you look at this and you think, well, $450. And it's very expensive to make these things. The process, what you see in front of you, I had to actually hand make that out of wood and Bondo and metal.
Right.
And we had to make the exact piece that we wanted. Then we had castings made of it. And then those castings were taken to a foundry. And then the foundry made what's called a tool.
Correct.
Out of metal. And then the tool has to get jigged up and cleaned and adjusted and pinned and everything else. And then it goes to another factory that makes the actual part. So you've got all these steps involved to make one piece and all this money spent before you even make one piece. And, you know, we've been in business for 15 years, but we really don't make any money because all the money we make from one unit goes into the next one.
Right.
So we make the next one. And then someday, hopefully when I retire, then we'll be in the green and we can make some money.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was going to say that, you know, this is something that's durable. That's going to last you a long time.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, something that you can do just about anything with it. I mean, you know, I'm pretty sure that you guys probably run across a lot of hobbyists out there that enjoy having these tanks and displaying them in their homes or in their businesses, things like that, you know?
Oh, absolutely. And the other really cool thing that I love is a lot of our customers, after they get the kits and they build them and they detail them out, they send us pictures back.
Oh,
so
right
if you check out our website, a lot of the pictures on our website are of customers' built vehicles that they have built and customized themselves.
Okay. And that website is, I think I have it right here. Mm-hmm. It's www.plasticpanzers.8k.com.
Correct.
Okay. And for the is there any other, is there a phone number where they can also maybe get a hold of you?
No, but yeah. I have an email right here.
Go ahead and read it to us.
My email is rich, R-I-C-H, dot BGV, Battleground Vehicles, just BGV though, at gmail.com.
Okay.
Anybody has questions, they can email me direct and be happy to work with them any way I can.
Yeah, Richard, and thank you for bringing these beautiful tanks out here today, man, and sharing them with, you know, the listeners and the viewers out there on the internet, man. Really beautiful, something that, you know, I would suggest, you know, hey, you want to do a hobby with your son or your daughter, man, this is the way to go. You know, like you said, a little expensive, but you know what? It's worth the build.
Exactly. And, you know, and that's the end result. And what's your time worth when you're enjoying it with your children and teaching them how to do something special that they'll remember the rest of their lives?
Absolutely. I totally agree with you. Yeah. Okay, folks, so that's Richard Harrow with Plastic Panzers. And, again, their website is www.plasticpanzers.8k.com, or you can email Richard at rich.bgv@gmail.com. Richard, thank you so much for being out here and sharing all this with us. And any last thing you'd like to say? Shout out to your lovely wife out there.
Yeah, I'd like to thank my wife, Pat, for being there and help supporting me through all these adventures.
Right on, man, and good luck and Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays,
and thank you
for being here. And before we go back to DJ CX2 right here, we just want to give a shout out to our sponsors. We have Sapo Plastic Tech in San Bernardino, you know, American made plastic tubing there for commercial and industrial use. Friendly service and great prices, so give them a call at 909-884-4433. 909-884-4433. And who do you have there, CR? CX2?
CR England. CR England Trucking, now hiring for diesel reefer, trailing mechanics, all positions open, top pay and benefits. Visit www.crengland.com or call 800-322-0370.
Yeah, and our last and final sponsor is jpjerky.com. If you're looking for some beef jerky, some great jerky, lemon, teriyaki, spicy, original, pepper, give them a call. Look them up at www.jpjerky.com. And right now we're going to go back to CX2 with some great jams.
Wasn't true, and you passed them by. Though you're in the scenery, and their lines don't mean a thing, why don't you let me try? Now I don't wear a diamond ring, I don't even know a song. Charms, I'm sure you will.
will see.
You will see.
The things I say are true. And the way I explain them to you. Listen to me.
La 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 la. I love you.
Oh, baby.
La 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 la. I love
let them know who it is. Drinking with the fellas at Chicano Park. The law never sweats us cause they know who we are. It goes B-I-E-J-I-T-O-S. Bumper scraping till I take my very last breath. It's the B-I-E-J-I-T-O-S. When you're rolling with us, you're rolling with the best. And it's front, back, side to side. I said who's in the house?
Viejitos worldwide.
It's the B-I-E-J-I-T-O-S. When you're rolling with us, you're rolling with the best. And it's front, back, side to side. I said who's in the house? Viejitos worldwide. It all started on a sunny California day, 9/16/85 in the city of LA. The bomb buzz are sitting low at East Lopes. California love represent on the West Coast, San Gabriel Valley. Throw it up for me. Index in the middle finger, throwing up the beat. It's a chapter roll call as we hit the IE. Gangsta white wall tires always rolling clean. San Bernardino always represents to the fullest. Orange County always down the party. Let's do this. San Diego, my hometown. Damn, I love this place. North County, SD. Cruising Chevrolets, then it's Tijuas, Jalisco, and Mexicali. When the beer's all gone, we'll head back to Cali. Oxnard, Palmdale, putting it down at shows. The high desert keeps it hot, let the straight pipes blow.
It's the B-I-E-J-I-T-O-S. When you're rolling with us, you're rolling with the best. And it's front, back, side to side. I said, who's in the house?
Viejitos worldwide.
It's the B-I-E-J-I-T-O-S. When you're rolling with us, you're rolling with the best. And it's front, back, side to side. I said who's in the house? You hit the worldwide.
Now let's raise a glass and make a toast for the Central Coast, up to Silicon Valley where they let the sirens blow. From Stockton to San Jose, all around the way, San Francisco represent all around the bay. Up in Reno it's popping, they're dropping those bombs. New Mexico always rolls, playing those oldie songs. Down in Texas, McAllen always makes it happen. Then it's up to Austin where the always cake happen. Then it's through Oklahoma as we jump to Northern Illinois. Nationwide till they feel the noise. Now grab your passport cause we're heading to Japan. Viejitos worldwide one more time so you understand. Maldito 39 tells the story through his soul. Hapachuco 48 ready to roll. Hapalita 50 chop top fleet line. Mafioso 36 let's go, it's cruising time.
It's the B-I-E-J-I-T-O-S. When you're rolling with us, you're rolling with the best. And it's front, back, side to side. I said who's in the house?
Viejitos worldwide.
It's the B-I-E-J-I-T-O-S. When you're rolling with us, you're rolling with the best. And it's front, back, side to side. I said who's in the house?
Viejitos worldwide.
Right on, that goes out to the Viejitos Nomads, to Georgie Marquecho, Snow Cone out there in the city of Riverside. Hope everything's going good, primo. And I want to give a shout-out out there to Street Life Car Club, Larry Diaz, del Presidente, man. Thanks for tuning in. And then I want to give a shout-out to the Hookup Wire and Wheels. If you're looking for some True Spoke Wire Wheels, get a hold of Jerry at 951-712-9984. And you're listening to The Commish and DJ CX2 right here at KCAA Radio, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, where no listener is left behind. And we're going to go back to CX2.
I was slipping.
All right, welcome back to Kcaa right here during the Suavecitos Sunday Squad Block. Right here is you have the commish along with DJ CX2 bringing you some great jams. And it's going down right here tonight at the Carousel Mall in the Northwest End parking lot. We have the Suavecitos Christmas Light Car Show. So come on down, decorate your car. We got trophies going on. There's going to be vendors out there. We have quite a few different food vendors that are going to be here with us tonight. So come on down from 6 to 9 o'clock. It's going down tonight right here at the Carousel Mall in the city of San Bernardino between 2nd and 3rd Street. So come on down, join us. And we got some upcoming events coming up. The Relay for Life team wobbles in the city of Colton, along with in coordination with Street Life Car Club, will be having their Colton cruise coming up on Saturday, March 19th, 2016. More details to come. If you'd like to be a vendor or a sponsor, you can call 909-319-3340, 909-319-3340. Or you can call 909-856-9558, 909-856-9558. And once again, man, come down, cruise with us down here at the Carousel Mall. The Suavecito Sunday Squad, we'll be doing it up for you out there like we always do, bringing the jams to you live out back behind the Carousel Mall. So come on down, bring the kids. There's going to be toys out there, some giveaways going on. So come on down and join the Suavecitos Car Club this Sunday evening. And I said earlier 6 to 9, but I understand it's 5 to 9 according to CX2. Is that correct? Well, talk into the mic because, you know, just don't shake your head.
Yeah.
Make some noise. You know, you've been here on the radio with me for a while now. It's your turn to start talking. Let me kick back. I want to retire. Sure, I want to go kick back with my primo snow cone. Yeah, have some snow cones while you're jamming here.
I want some.
All right, so let's go back to CX2, man. What you got for us, CX2?
Don't be confused the way
right, and you're listening to The Commission, DJ CX2, right here at Kcaa Radio, 1050 AM and 106.5 FM, the station that leaves no listener behind. And we're with the Suavecito Sunday Squad, and you'll be able to find us tonight right here from 5 to 9 at the Carousel Mall. We have our second annual Christmas car show, Christmas-like car show and toy drive. So come on by, bring the kids out. We have vendors out there. We have food vendors. The Suavecitos are going to be doing it up. They got trophies for all the beautiful cars that will be displayed out there. I believe the cost is like either a toy or $10. Don't quote me on that, but come on by and have some great fun with the Suavecitos Car Club. And once again, I want to thank my primos for all their support. You guys watching in, I want to thank all the internet viewers that are out there. I'm lost for words right now. But thank you guys all for tuning in to the Commission Show every Sunday from 3 to 4. And remember, man, we kick it off with the Suavecito Sunday Squad at 1 p.m. You're listening to Crazy Ray with X-Ray Productions. And then at 2 o'clock, we have the Spin Junkies with Boogie Brown and JoJo Devotions and Eerie Voodoo Doll, always jamming it up. And then every Sunday at 3 o'clock to 4, you have right here, you have the Commish along with DJ CX2. And you got some final words there, DJ CX2?
Shout out to our primos in Orange County, Primo Louie and Joni and Aunt Helen and everybody out there.
That's right, man. And a shout out to Beto out there with Gato Southern Cal Car Club, man. You guys are always tuning in to the Commish. I enjoy all the support that the Gatos and the Dead Sleds, CP, the president out there, man. You guys are always, supporting me. Anyways, so this is the Commish, man. I'm going to let DJ CX2 finish the last few minutes here up with some great jams. And I'm going to be signing off. And like I tell you guys, man, remember, live the American dream, cruise low and slow.
So cruel, nevertheless, I say, you gotta be waiting, sitting in the park, waiting for you. No, I'm not gonna wait, I am tired of waiting, no longer gonna wait.
If you This is 1050 AM, Kcaa, Loma Linda, and 106.5 FM, Yucaipa.
I'm Keith Irizarry. Despite giving away a 35-14 lead, the Panthers got a 43-yard field goal from Graham Gano. Get the win. Carolina improves to 14-0. Kirk Cousins at it again as the Redskins took care of the Bills 35-20.